Good afternoon, my learners, biology, a high level at Zeller's Tutorial Center. This is Bangula. I'm presenting to you the lesson that was remaining on digestion, human alimentary canal. We are going to continue with 6.3.2 according to the notes which I have given you, and that's what I'm going to try to explain today. Okay? The first thing that you need to explain 6.3.2, where you have, for example, definitions, you should be able to define all those things like ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation, egestion. For a high level learner, this is, no one is going to ask you the definition of these things, but you must know what they stand for. 6.3.3 is about digestion. So what exactly is digestion? Digestion is a process whereby large insoluble molecules are converted from insoluble large molecules to soluble smaller molecules, which are able to be used by the body. So that's why we need digestion. Because molecules, if they are too large, they cannot pass through the wall of the ileum. They cannot pass through the wall of the colon to be able to go in the blood so that we can use them. So we need to digest and break them down so that they can pass through the wall, through the carrier proteins, okay? Through the carrier protein active transport, so and it's only using molecules. So we cannot have large molecules. And this is to remind you that what you absorb is nutrients and not food. That's why food must be broken down so the nutrients can be isolated, then you can take out the nutrients. The rest is what we remove out as stool or feces, okay? Let's go to the teeth. The teeth. Teeth are those bony structures, the one we use to crush. So I'm sure by now you know the different types of teeth in our mouth and what to use them for. As a high level learner, we don't have to ask you what teeth are used for, but you take it for granted that you know them, you know what they are used for, and what shape they have and why they have those kind of shapes. Okay, you have your canines, and you have incisors, which are for cutting, canines for pulling and biting. You have pre and molars, which are there for crushing the food. Okay, so those things we know for now. Now let's go to dental decay. If you talk about teeth, you must be able to look after them because they help us to digest. The teeth carry out the process which we call mechanical digestion. They form part of mechanical digestion, breaking down food material into smaller pieces so that a further digestion can take place, a different form, which is chemical digestion, which we are going to talk about a bit later. But for now, for mechanical digestion, you need the teeth. Now, these teeth, you must look after them. Now, if you don't look after them, then you might have actually what you call dental decay. So what is the cause of dental decay? Dental decay is whereby you have teeth rotting. They rot because of acids. The bacteria which are in your mouth, they feed on the sugar which remains in your mouth, okay? And the food particles which are in your mouth, they feed off of them, then they release acids. Acids are the one which digest the enamel, which is the hardest part of the tooth, the outside one. Then they go to the dentine, which is soft, and then the acid go there. When the acid go there, they irritate the nerves. When the nerves are irritated, you feel the pain. And then you say you have a headache, we have a toothache. So that is because of the acid which are produced by bacteria. Okay? Not the food, it's the acid, and not the bacteria, it's the acid. Please. How do you prevent tooth decay? Tooth decay can be prevented by doing the following. You can do it by avoiding sugary food. Okay? Brush regularly with a toothpaste. And then replace your toothbrush every 3 months because the bristles can be out of shape and they can become soft and they won't be able to clean properly. And of course, use the right way of brushing. Please, when you're brushing, make a cycle. A cycle like that. Don't just go like that. I know that's what some people do. Don't do that, okay? You make cycles so that the bristles are forced to go between the teeth. You should floss regularly. Floss is a string that you can buy in the shop so that you can coil on one finger and then press it with your teeth, with your thumbs, then you can move it between the teeth. Then you pull, then you can pull out any food remaining that may be in the mouth. Use mouthwash, okay? There's a liquid that you can buy to put in the mouth, at least also to help to keep the mouth smelling fresh. Chew crispy food, apples, pears, those food that help to, when you are biting them, there's a friction between them and the teeth. They help to clean the teeth somehow. And then visit the dentist regularly. Don't just go there when you are sick or when you have a toothache. Go there also so that the doctor can check and prevent any form of problems that can develop later. For example, you can get people who are getting what? Impacted teeth. Now, before they go too far, the doctor can find it early. Or your teeth are maybe crooked, they need to be straightened. They should be found early so that they can straighten them on time. If there's one which is getting rotten, it should be removed or be treated well so that it does not affect others. So it's always recommended that you visit your dental doctor, okay? Yeah, you can also use a fluoride toothpaste. So a fluoride toothpaste is a toothpaste, you can see here it is written fluoride, okay? This one will say clinically proven fluoride toothpaste. So fluoride toothpaste, they can help to strengthen your teeth. Okay, that's why it's written long lasting. Some of the things are maybe for advertising, but the fact is that fluoride actually does strengthen our teeth. So we can have it in the toothpaste, we can also have it in the water. Okay, let's go to the action of fluoride. The probable action of fluoride in reducing tooth decay. Okay, together with calcium, fluoride, they do strengthen the teeth and the bones. Okay, it can be added to drinking water to benefit a wider population, not only some people. Okay, so when you have fluoride in the teeth, you are taking fluoride inside, it strengthens the teeth, not only the teeth, also your bones. If you are active in sport, okay, you need the bones to be dense and strong. So some of these food supplements and this cleaning, they have some other, you know, benefits which are not directly, you know, coming to you in the way you are using them, like the fluoride in the toothpaste. Okay, let's talk about the fluoride in the water. Okay, in the water, the fluoride in the water, I gave it to you in your notes, you will see that one. Fluoride, we say, when it is added to water, to drinking water, like NAM water, for example, can add it to its bulk water supply to the town council. Now, why? It helps to reduce tooth decay, and then it also helps to reduce the money that you spend to go to the doctor. You don't have to keep going to the doctor with rotten teeth. You don't have to keep going to the doctor because you have headache, and the doctor has to treat you. Then you have to use tax money. So it saves you money. So you're just drinking water, you get fluoride, and that is a good thing about it. But there are some people who argue against it. They say after fluoride has been added to the water, it discolors the water. It becomes a bit whitish. That's why sometimes you see whitish water coming out at some time of the month. Okay? It could be chlorine, which has been added to kill bacteria, but there's also fluoride added to help the people to get strong teeth. It has been researched that people who use fluoride openly, there are less incidences among them of tooth decay. So that's why it is just given free of charge to everybody to benefit. Okay, that's a good thing. Now some people say it also perhaps this gives a bad taste to the water. The water will taste differently, so some people don't like the taste. So those are some of the arguments against the addition of fluoride to the water. Okay, yeah. And then in some parts of the world, yeah, it is already too high. Now when you add it, it can become too much and it can discolor the teeth. You might have seen some people from the south of Namibia, you will see them with some brownish things on the teeth. It's because sometimes of fluoride. Okay, so it becomes too much, so you shouldn't use too much. So it's just in a small amount. Okay, that is now with the teeth. Let us go to the process of chewing. The process of chewing. What exactly is chewing? Chewing.